When will Starship SN11 launch? It's been less than 2 weeks since SpaceX's epic Starship SN10 rocket landing and subsequent explosion, and the company is already gearing up for another test flight of SN11. The world cannot wait for Starship SN11 to do the soft landing right and not explode. In this video, we took a look into Starship SN11's upcoming launch, all the related events, and the key updates made to SN11. Starship SN11 is the latest in a family of huge rocket prototypes built by SpaceX to test systems required for its massive Starship and Super Heavy rockets, the core of a new, fully reusable launch system the company hopes to use for trips to the Moon, Mars, and beyond. SpaceX has made incremental tweaks and upgrades to its Starship design after each test flight as it works to perfect the new launch system. SN11, this will be the fourth high-altitude test flight of the prototype Starship. SN11 will mark the final test of this iteration of Starship before the program moves into the next phase of testing following SN11 flight. SpaceX will move on to SN15 heavy prototypes, BN1 and BN2, before shooting for an orbital launch with SN20 and BN3. By the way, show us some love and remember to subscribe to our channel, Futurephile, to watch more videos about such fascinating futuristic tech. On March 8, SpaceX rolled out Starship serial number 11, SN11, from the assembly site to the launch pad to perform pre-flight preparations. All three Raptors were installed. By March 9, the Starship SN11 vehicle underwent a cryogenic proof test. During a cryogenic pressurization test, the stainless steel vehicle was filled with liquid nitrogen to simulate the stress pressure the vehicle will experience with cryogenic propellants in flight. The next pre-flight test is expected to be a static fire test in which Starship SN11's three Raptor engines will be fueled with cryogenic propellants, liquid methane, and liquid oxygen. The engines will be briefly ignited. The static fire test was expected by the end of last week. However, issues understood to be related to GSE, ground support equipment, delayed the firing of SN11's Raptors, with the weekend not available for testing due to the requirement to close Highway 4 during such tests. SpaceX only requests a handful of weekend road closures to keep local disruption to a minimum. The latest static fire window was set for Monday morning, with the potential to launch the following day. However, this was pending acceptable weather conditions. Despite the foggy conditions, SN11 did attempt the test before aborting shortly after pre-burner ignition. Another attempt is set for NET, no earlier than Wednesday morning. The FAA, Federal Aviation Administration, formally authorized the SN11 flight, as reported from the Washington Post's Christian Davenport on Monday. SpaceX fans are desperate to see the Starship SN11 take to the skies, more so than any previous Starship prototype. SN11 has big boots to fill after the SN10 launched and landed at the company's Boca Chica facility in South Texas earlier this month. And though the prototype rocket blew up just 8 minutes after the touchdown, Elon Musk's army of devout fans is convinced SN11 will be the first rocket to survive in one piece. On Monday, March 15, SpaceX undertook one final dress rehearsal before SN11 can launch on its maiden voyage. SpaceX is aiming to make the Starship orbital before the year is over if humans are going to reach Mars before the decade is out. The SN11 began igniting its Raptor engines during a static fire test just before 5:30 p.m. Greenwich Mean Time, 12:30 p.m. Central Daylight Time. But the test was almost immediately scrubbed, even as flames and smoke appeared around the SN11's base. According to Tesla righties Eric Ralph, the fire ignited something inside of the rocket as the flames did not die out for 30 to 40 seconds after the abort. This puts SpaceX in a good position to reattempt the static fire test on Wednesday. And once that last hurdle is cleared, SN11 should be cleared for its first suborbital test flight. SN11's launch will mark only the fourth high-altitude flight of a Starship prototype. Starship SN11 will reattempt a static fire test following a scrub on Monday ahead of a potential flight later this week. But this is always subject to change due to numerous factors and considerations ranging from weather hardware parameters and Federal Aviation Administration's paperwork approval. A lot of key upgrades were made in SN11 as compared to SN10. Elon Musk and SpaceX seems to be in a hurry to build rapid prototypes, launch, fail, learn, and eventually make better and more functional prototypes. And they are doing it at an unprecedented scale. Shouts of joy erupted from space lovers from all over the world when the SpaceX's SN10, the previous version of Starship, made a touchdown on the 3rd of March. It seems the SN10 has achieved something its predecessors couldn't. It has passed its test flight successfully. However, a few minutes after its landing, boom, it erupted into a familiar inferno like most of its predecessors. Immediately after the SN10 went up in flames, as expected, a lot of questions were left unanswered. Even though most people already have an idea of the likely cause of the explosion, they still want to be sure by hearing from the horse's mouth, in this case, Elon Musk, the CEO of SpaceX. As expected, many people marched to Twitter to ask several questions, and in a recent tweet by Elon Musk on March 9, he revealed what went wrong with the SN10 in a few responses to those queries. Musk said that the SN10 engine was low on thrust, and that was probably due to partial helium ingestion from the fuel header tank. The impact crushed the rocket's legs and a part of its skirt, he added. Just before the landing, and Starship does the horizontal to vertical reorientation, this causes a lot of sloshing in the fuel and causes a drop in pressure that was the root cause of explosion of SN8. To avoid this sloshing of fuel, and in order to maintain the pressure necessary to feed fuel to the engines, there was a last-minute decision in SN10 to add helium pressure into the header tanks. It was designed to keep that pressure maintained on the fuel so that it would keep feeding into the engines during the landing process. But as Elon points out in his tweet that the engine started to consume that helium, this resulted in reducing the thrust and leading to the violent landing. So, considering the newly created problem that helium has brought in SN10, SpaceX has decided to remove helium pressure in the header tank. SpaceX is currently working on multiple fixes for the issue so that it does not affect the SN11. Also, Chris Bergen from NASA Space Flight tweeted that the issue was a tricky one, since the helium ingestion was caused by the pressurization system added to the methane tank to prevent what caused the SN8 Starship to explode. In SN10, the legs deployed at touchdown appeared to collapse, and as water hoses attempted to extinguish a fire at the base of SN10, it sprung upwards and exploded. For SN11, the landing leg has been lowered individually. They have been rigorously tested by SpaceX's employees. Landing leg strength were improved, and there will be 6 landing legs in SN11. In a tweet I mentioned before, Elon Musk added that for SN11, they are going to use 2 Raptor engines all the way to touchdown. And if any of the 2 Raptor engines underperform, the flight computer will automatically relight the 3rd one to make sure the landing velocity remains low and under control. SpaceX is putting a lot of heat tiles in the SN11. SpaceX really wants this vessel to recover from the heat. For the first time, you are seeing a patch of heat tiles on a flap, and this is something that the Starship is going to need. And every little bit of the vessel is going to have to be protected from the intense heat of re-entry. The whole point of Starship is to prove that rockets can take off, do a belly flop, and then do a horizontal to vertical reorientation, then do a soft landing. It is so unconventional and so challenging from an aerodynamic and rocket design standpoint. SN10 almost did everything right, but the finishing wasn't on point. With all these upgrades on header tank, legs, Raptor, heat management, there is high probability that SN11 will be the first Starship prototype to do a soft landing after a complex high-altitude flight. Elon seems to be an impatient man. He wants to get it done with SN11 and soon move to SN15. And with such rapid pace that everything is proceeding, it is likely that Starship SN11 launch is just days ahead. If you like this video, make sure to check out our other videos on why SN11 won't fail, shown in the end screen. See you there.